Saver è una mostra che è perfettamente in linea col DNA del Centro Tecci. Sin dalla sua apertura la musica è stato uno dei linguaggi prediletti nella programmazione, a partire dall'evento inaugurale e poi per tutti gli anni a seguire attraverso una serie di concerti, di focus specifici, di mostre come Live, la mostra dedicata al rapporto tra rock e arte visiva. Night Fever quindi viene a proseguire un percorso già iniziato da tempo e lo fa affrontando il tema della notte, dei locali dove a partire dagli anni 60 si è svolta una del tutto peculiare commistione tra i vari linguaggi della creatività.
It touches on so many different disciplines. It touches on architecture, on interior design, product and graphic design, fashion of the people who go out to dance and dress up, and even installation art, performance art.
C'è poi un'altra motivazione specifica per cui Night Fever è la mostra giusta per il Centro Tecci, e cioè che l'inizio del percorso identificato dai curatori parte proprio da questo territorio, dalle esperienze degli architetti radicali in Toscana e quindi da discoteche come lo Space Electronic o il Mach 2 ideati dai 9999 o da Super Studio.
A main starting point for this exhibition was the realization that in Italy in the 1960s and 1970s there was a very strong connection between the world of design and architecture and the world of nightclubs. It's very much about creating modular, transformable spaces that can change depending on what is happening in the space, be it just dancing, be it a concert, a theater play, even exhibitions. They also thought about creating immersive spaces with media all around you, projections. Things were filmed and then again projected. So it's really about the idea of having many different influences to your senses, visual, acoustic, which is something we're discussing again today in the digital world, these immersive environments. We wanted to take it broader. We wanted to show how the design and architecture for nightclubs changed over time, over decades, and also broaden it geographically, not to look only at Italy, but also look at other countries and other cities in Europe and North America mainly. These clubs were often kind of, nowadays you would say startups, because it was really young people who wanted to create a new kind of space, and so they commissioned other artists, architects, designers to create something for them. And it's actually, those were places where many careers were started for architects, designers and artists. Many of those flyers and posters that were created were really great graphic design to invite people to come to the clubs. People like Keith Haring, who actually designed many flyers for clubs, that was one of his starting points. We have created a silent disco, a room within a room that you can walk into and then listen through playlists of the pre-disco times, disco, house, techno, with a really fantastic light installation. I think the club world today is in a kind of difficult moment. And there are a number of reasons for that. I think one main one is the digital era today. It used to be that you had to go to a club to listen to a certain new music first. That's where you heard it first. Nowadays, music is available everywhere. We have it on our phones. These other functions of being avant-garde places were important some decades ago. Nowadays, there's many other institutions that have taken on this role, such as museums of contemporary art or galleries. Those clubs used to be places where people could do crazy things because they weren't made public. What happened in the club stayed in the club. Nowadays, everyone's bringing his phone and photographing it and posting it 5 minutes later. So that doesn't happen anymore.
Fever è una mostra che può interessare veramente a tutti, a una generazione più grande perché queste esperienze le ha vissute e quindi può ricordarle attraverso i molti materiali presentati nelle sale. A chi invece è troppo giovane per essere stato in uno qualsiasi dei locali rappresentati da Night Fever, può arrivare un messaggio dirompente, cioè che la cultura può essere divertimento.